Welcome back to the bathhouse from before. People were saying that I should have taken a rest here. So let's give that a shot. I need a room. Last time I got a dance scene, so if nothing else, maybe something something amusing will happen. It's that corridor over there. Enjoy your stay. Also, it opens a door, so I should probably get a room at every location anyway, because there could be something in said room. Oh yeah, there it is. That's something right there. A glowing cube with 4 stars inside. Must be what that guy with the wig was looking for. 5. I already have 5 out of 7, wow. Nice room, huh? Yeah? She's chilling by the fire. She's laying down under the table. that looks pretty normal, actually, I guess. The way the pillows are propped up and all the food's set up. I've just never quite assumed that posture before. You could rest here if you wanted. Which, I don't need healing right now, so not the biggest deal ever. But it exists! That's a thing that happens. Oops. Also, it's very close to the save point, and very easy to do an accident. Here we go. That's the original reason why, would you like to do this? Prompts happened in the first place, was games where it was easy to try to accidentally perform multiple different actions in spite of each other, so you would get a prompt asking if you were sure. Not that I'm going to complain extensively about a few seconds lost at no cost. Have we been to that portal before? Is that the one I tried and failed at, or no? That's probably the academy. Or not, I don't know. There's a lot of landmarks on this map. The important thing is whenever I last came by, I've probably leveled up since then, so maybe I could take out this portal. That may or may not be the one that kicked my ass before. I think I also built up some elemental resistance on my equipment. Hello! Oh. Hi. I don't think you're the same one from before, because I don't think that one had these guys in it, the beholders. Unless it just didn't have, maybe it didn't have beholders because I never met them before? No, because we've had portal enemies that were guys I've never met before. So I think this might be a different one than the one I failed at. I should figure out where that one is in the first place. That AoE is so powerful. Alright, I leveled up again. So we're gonna wait for this to load. There we go. Work towards maxing this tree out again. More resistances. You know, let's go into ice affinity and resistance next. I've gotten to the point where I can get both the resistance types. I might as well max out every resistant type across the board, since the most dangerous thing in this game is elemental projectiles. So if I can max out every elemental resistance, even though they're not big bonuses, they're like 4 and 6% and stuff like that, it'll be something. Wow, that hurts. Got one. Quickly, keep attacking them while they're down. They can't fight back when they're underground. That seems like an oversight that you can attack them underground. I've said that before, I'm sure, but it seems so strange that that works. Hello, ghosties. Ow. My pain. Ow. Problem. There we go. That helps. And we're clear. Loot all the bodies. We need so much money right now. I really wish the bodies didn't disappear. And here's the bad guys. The guys that attack you with falling elemental attacks. That's rough. Just gotta keep working on them. If I get any of them low on health, I should probably target that one more to try to continue to damage the same guy. Come on. Every one of them I can remove from the fight is progress. Oop, watch out. There we go, one down. Oop, watch out. Alright, I don't think I'm playing that much better than last time, but I don't really remember last time very well. But I think my stats may have improved enough to make me not die as abruptly as I was last time. So I mostly remember dying shockingly abruptly last time. Uh-oh, they're staggering their attacks. That's not good. They're using 2 different attacks at the same time now. Until now, they were kind of doing both at the same time. I mean, they're all kind of in sync doing one attack, one action together. Okay. Aha, I can do that one too. Oopsie, I'm dying. Oh, and I don't have a healing potion ready. Oh no. This is how it happens. Just a second longer. There we go. We gotta be careful. That cooldown on being able to heal is long. There we go. Go down, go down. They're so massively more dangerous than like every other enemy in the game so far. Is those spellcasters. Even these guys, like they might hit hard or something, I don't know. But they're so slow. Oh wow, they are durable too. I'm gonna hang out over here. This might be a long one. I wonder if this is an even higher level mission than the one I've done on- Oh crap, am I getting stuck? This might be an even higher level mission than the one that I failed at, because it has an extra wave. Oh right, I wouldn't know whether or not the other one had an extra wave, because I didn't beat that wave. Do I want to use the energy potion, or just tank this one out, is the question. By the way, I gotta say, this game, somewhat infamously, there's no options menu, and you can't really, like, I don't think you can really mess with the video, the audio very much, and man, this music is so loud. Like, I've reduced the window, in my Windows settings, I've reduced the music volume, so it doesn't constantly overpower my brain. But it's so loud, and the game audio is so loud on top of that, that it leads to an effect that the metal music playing stacked with these guys, the heavy thunder steps and everything, is actually leading to like the audio getting blown out because it's like above maximum decibels for how computers actually process audio. It's just one specific part of this game is way better than all the other parts of this game. Like, the writing totally surpasses the old technical aspects in a way that's a little astonishing. This is taking forever. I'll see you guys in like 10 minutes when I take these guys down, I guess.
Can it be? Are we almost victorious?
By the way, I try to sneak into the melee attack every now and then, but it's not really worth it. It kind of feels like fighting those ogres from the beginning of Dark Souls 2, where their hitboxes are really weird and don't feel finished. It's like you roll in and you miss with your melee attack, and then they hit you with their melee attack even though you're rolling away, and I'm like, ah, crap. Ooh, money. Ooh, 200 each. Now what are we at? We're getting there. I believe I needed 5 grand for those glasses. Hello. That seems like a pretty strong bonus across the board. I'm gonna go with that. There we go. Is that our first rank 8 item? Yeah, it is. That was probably worth it. I haven't kept really good track, but by my estimation, I'm trying to remember. It's been a little while now. I think he said there was 9 portals, and I got a reward instantly for getting at least 5 of them. We don't know if that was 5 or 6 or 7. Like, we don't know how many I had completed at that point. We just know that I had completed at least 5 by then. I've now completed 2 more since that conversation, so I have at least 7 done, possibly more. We'll have to keep an eye out. Is that one rotating? Oh, they all rotate even when they're broken. Okay. That's fine. So are you a cemetery? The big question is whether this is the abandoned school or if it's the cemetery I was already at. Nope, this is new. This straight up looks like a location from Diablo 3. Well, I sincerely hope I don't die. Oh, right. There's that one nice thing about this game, which is that, If you enter a location like this and die, you restart the location. You don't have to go all the way back to your save. So that one portal will still be done, at least. That's good. But yeah, this is almost certainly the abandoned academy. I'm sure I tried to enter it before and it didn't let me in. That's the wrong button. There we go. Oh, these guys again, huh? Hi there. Ow, that hurt a lot. Also, a line attack seems like a pretty devastating thing for you to have in this kind of setting, doesn't it? Oh, man. So that's where we're gonna fight these guys, huh? Oh, he's not spawning here. Die, die, die. Yay! 80 gold. How are we doing on healing items? 9? That's probably enough to get me through, but I should probably buy more as soon as I can. We leveled up again, so now I'm maxing out my ice affinity. And I believe I got... maxed out fire resistance by 8%. Weird. You put 3 points into earth affinity and ice affinity. I mean resistance. Wait, is it the resistance one? Yeah. You put 3 points into ice and earth resistance for 6% bonus, but you put 4 points into fire resistance for an 8% bonus. Your skill tree is biased against certain elements, weirdly enough. But obviously most of my resistance comes from equipment anyway, because we're talking about a single-digit bonus to what is currently almost a three-digit bonus in some of these cases. 71, 82, 49. I need to get the fire resistance up, because that, Oh, wait, no, that's an earth attack. Wow, that's a damaging attack, huh? They're doing this to me, which I can confirm is earth-based because it's my attack. I was thinking a fire for a moment there because of the fact that it does look reddish, orangish, like fire. But I use that attack and it's earth. So with a 82% or 82 rating of earth resistance, it does that much damage. That's surprising. I need to stop pressing that button at the wrong times. Fuck off. There we go. Just beat him out of it. There we go. Glad I got that passive health resistance, the passive health and stamina recovery, even if it doesn't always amount to much. It's something. I'm seriously on my way to maxing out the entire tree of this game, which is not usually how that works in any game. Yeah, this very much feels like a location I'd see in a Diablo game. That's a weird distribution of pillars in that corner. Money, money, how we doing? We'll get there. I'll probably get 5k over the course of this run, essentially being able to complete both missions simultaneously. Odd that there's a chest you can't open. Weird. Yeah, this is like Act 1 of Diablo 3, I would say, is this entire location. It looks like you're like under Tristram and stuff, looking for Deckard Cain in that crater. Ah, oh god. These guys now, huh? Wish me luck, guys. Ah ha ha. That audio is so crushed and probably. Oh no! Oh no! That audio is really unfortunate, but so is the giant earth attacks that crush you. Oh. This is gonna be a tad unfair, isn't it? Yeah, in a game where you get mobbed by enemies, that one specific attack is like totally out of balance with every other enemy I've met before. Because they have a series of falling ice attacks that you can't escape, and a series of line-based earth attacks that are also hard to escape, and then they make you fight them in a confined area. At least in the portal level, it was a big open field where you could evade those attacks. Don't worry, I got this. I'm definitely not doomed. Hey, look, it's the anti-hero's cap and a mimic hat. Oh god, they can shoot the... How'd they even shoot that direction? That's weird. Watch out. Run away. And then get out of the way, because they're going to do the earth attack now. Pain. Roll. There's so much danger on the screen. Oh my god. There we go, it's two down. Significant reduction in danger. Oh crap, the attack's still coming. Oh no, they're staggering now. Are they programmed to do that when there's two of them for some reason? I wonder. There we go. They might be programmed to specifically stagger their attacks when there's two of them. Or it might just be that at that point their behavior becomes too erratic. That's a straight up mimic. It doesn't seem like it does anything. This must be the hat of the anti-hero. It's one of the items Paradigm Agit needed. And that was the sound of an incoming spellcaster attacker, I think. Teleporting in. Nice touch with the mimic. Does it have a tongue? I can't tell if it's a tongue or just like a ribbon hanging out of its mouth. I kind of wish I could see the other side of it a little better, just to be sure, but I wanted to see if it specifically had the Dark Souls chain that indicates that it's a mimic or not. Obviously, mimics are in everything, but I was just curious to see if it'd be a specific callback or not. It'd be kind of neat to see. Just die, you're alone. There we go. I know I heard the sound of him warping in. How are we doing on money? Hey, 5 grand. We did it. And all I have to do is lose all my money. All of it. Can I go over here at all? No? Just wondering if there's anything worthwhile around here. Some of these parts look so much like Diablo. I'd hope to at least find like maybe A treasure chest or a Dragon Ball cube, lizard cube of lizardy cubiness. They don't grant wishes. They grant premonitions. Ooh. Wait, he said that I could use one of the wishes because he only needs one. I thought there was... In Dragon Ball, I think he just grants one wish. Does he grant more than one wish in this specific incarnation? They can make up the rules as they go along, I guess. Ah! Oh, God. My health. My poor health. Ha-ha! There we go. Bad mix to deal with the melee and ranged characters simultaneously. Gets me in trouble. Oh, no. Quickly, before he does anything else. Is he dead yet? Yeah, he is. There's the money. He done showed me the money, and I am dying right now. That's not good. So now we're on the far right side. It's like a mirror image of the left side we saw before, with that one circular outcrop. Hi. No. I may need to backtrack, because I'm pretty sure I saw an alternate path back there. But you never know which ones are going to be side paths and which ones are going to go somewhere. Nope, we got texture flicker. We got two. I always wonder what causes that error. I see it in a lot of games that I call it texture flicker. I don't know what it's actually called necessarily, but it's when two textures seem to overlap each other, and so they're both trying to. It's like they're both animating on alternating frames through each other because the engine doesn't know which one to show. Oh my god, my health! No, stop attacking me! I can't heal. I'm still waiting on the potion cooldown, which is not very effective to begin with. Ow! Alright, the potions people are dropping for me aren't helping me anymore. I think I need to go find, a store that sells, like better potions somewhere and try to stock up on them. Which is kind of a bummer, because I'm about to try to spend all my money on something else, but, eh. God damn. All this waiting for one potion cooldown. There we go. Ow! Also, in a game that has evasion in it, that's not a very evadable attack. I guess, I should be blocking it is the thing. I should be like, oh, he's gonna do the earth attack, and then I should be blocking, and then attacking the moment it's over. That's on me. Hey guys, be dead. Unfortunately for you, I have a lot of mana, because I was waiting for an opportunity to attack without dying. So my blue bar filled right up. Alright, let's go grab whatever this is. Special ability added while dodging. Don't know what that means. Let's find out. Increased fire damage. What's this one down here? Oh, ice sword combo. I'll go for the last passive. Otherwise, we're going to be done with this entire skill tree. Jeez. Alright. Oh, hey, there it is. Glowing cube with two stars inside. Must be the guy I was looking for. Six. I have 6 out of 7 already. Whoa. Can't touch this. Excuse me? Whoa! I'm the Flash now? I'm too old for this shit. This thing's great. Oh, but it uses up my stamina, so I gotta be careful about that. Yeah, actually, that's... Oh, man, I'm a little iffy about that, actually. On one hand, it's a really cool move that dashes around like crazy and can get you through... It'd be good for backtracking and progress and running around quickly and stuff like that. On the other hand, it uses up my mana, which I could use for everything else. So now my basic dodge has gotten bad for my mana, because I have to regenerate it over time, and my regeneration's way slower than the rate at which I could use it by dodging. And I can never turn it off. It's not toggleable. If they wanted to add that ability, they probably should have made it a second skill. Like, you press a different button to make that one happen. Kind of like how The Witcher has a dodge and a roll that are two separate actions. That would make more sense, because I'm pretty sure my dodge didn't use energy previously, and now it's been permanently replaced with a new skill that does use energy, and the tooltip doesn't tell you that's going to happen when you buy the skill, and that's kind of a alarming change to my build in some ways. This dungeon should be out of enemies, though, so I can thankfully just use it willy-nilly here, and it shouldn't be a big deal. Yay! There's the portal. I mean, the entrance. Alrighty then. Atchet's gonna be happy with me. Let's see, can I spot one last portal somewhere? It'd be great to finish that up while we're going around. I'm also curious to see if there's any more side quests left in this game. Obviously, I need to get the Dragon Ball. I wish I could dodge in this overworld. That'd be nice. Get away from all these spiders that always want to chase me. That's the portal. And that's the lodge. Or that's a different lodge. I actually don't think I have a reason to go there right now. Or was that the inn that had Ashton in? Now I run into the issue of not knowing where that guy was. Oh, there's a portal. I mean, there's two of them around here, and I'm clearly more capable of taking out certain enemies, so I might as well try to wrap that up, too.
Wizard's block.
Oh. I had no energy, so I couldn't use any attacks. That's a bummer. Watch out. Oh, this is really gonna mess with me. Oh, no. The whole basis of me using melee or even using my shockwave was to do it really quick and then dodge away, and now my dodge has been permanently replaced with a dash that uses up energy? And part of the reason I'm running away is to regenerate energy. Oh no, game. No. What a weird design choice. Alright, well, here's some experience for me. We'll see how this next area goes with these new rules in place. Alright. And I'm doing all this right now because the story is mostly linear, so I feel like if I finish doing this stuff, we might immediately get followed up with more linear story going up to the end of the game, for all I know. It's hard to say for sure, but either way, at least I'll be able to say I got it all done now, and we don't have to worry about it. So we have three objectives. Four objectives. Dragon Balls, portals, glasses, which I now have money for, and I'm stocking up some more. Oh my god, they're not coming out of the portal. Dragon Balls, glasses, hatchet, and portals. Wait, three? I was gonna say, wasn't there more than three of you? One of them just kind of gave up. Alright, so you're not gonna see me using dodge as much, I guess, now, because it's now more of a only vital situation only skill, because it's bad for me. Wow, they take damage fast. That's gonna be a hard... Oh crap, I'm walking into the rocks. I was getting stuck. That's gonna be a hard habit to break. It just feels natural to dodge away out of, like, constantly. But it's gonna make it so I can't use any more magic. And I like my magic. It's a vital part of who I am. Can I reloot that one? Oh, there's one more. Cool. How are we doing on items? Over 6 grand. Alright. I believe it was 5 grand for the glasses. So we should be good to go there. Oh my god, I'm getting strong. Ow, they're getting strong. Just die. There we go, one down. Unfortunately, as far as I can tell, the worms go underground, so you can't loot them. Wait, why are you guys here? I thought I already fought the ghost wave. I thought you guys were first. Were those ones not supposed to sneak out? Was that an accident? Swing! And loot money! And probably heal. Alright. Hey guys. I probably should not be attacking you with earth because you're trees. Although the earth would dampen your fire, and maybe the fire is your power. Oh, there's apparently a box inside that wall. That was weird. Oh, I can do that with surprisingly little blue on my meter right now. That's a surprise. There's no money in this group? Okay. Alright, one more down. And we got some more higher level potions. I should probably map those. There we go. They're now down on the D-pad. Those are more effective potions, but they're much more rare, obviously. So I've got to be a little careful with that. But we'll see. Alright, Zenith. Let's go take out what may or may not be your last portal, because I'm not entirely sure, because I've lost count, but... Oh, no, it has to be the last... No, well... If my numbers are correct, it has to be the last portal, because I did five... He said I did five, and I think he said there was nine. And this will be the fourth one since that conversation, so it has to be the last... Well, it has to be number nine, if I'm remembering that much correctly. But I might be misremembering him saying that there was nine portals in the first place. That might be wrong. Either way, let's find out. This might be the one that I was stuck on before. If it has spellcasters. We'll see. Hey guys, how you doing? Oh god. Why are you guys doing that now? You didn't used to do that, did you? Like a weird number of ambushes just sort of teleport in around me at the beginning of the fight. That seems like it's not supposed to work that way. Alright. Thank you. I'll take care of that problem for you.
You seem to be having an imp problem.
I find that to be improper. Oh, crap. Crap. This game... The looting in this game is not combat friendly. But you have to do it because the corpses disappear. It's one thing to grab money, or like to have do a quick money run before the corpses disappear, but it's a little rough if you have the surprise reveal of there being actual loot. It's like, oh crap, I don't have time to pick up real loot. There we go. I really wish I could loot money off of those guys, but their corpses are underground. That also seems unintentional. Yeah, this is a pretty slipshod RPG, unfortunately. It almost makes it feel slightly iffy the way that it's poking fun at all the other RPGs, because it itself is not a particularly good one. But I still appreciate the writing. The writing's funny enough that it makes me overlook everything else about the game. Hi. No. No ice. There's only two of you, though, huh? That's a surprise. I should be blocking right now. Yep, there's the... Ow, crap! Pain... Oh, I can use both healing potions independently of each other. Weird. Alright, we're just gonna use all melee and dodging against these guys. Ow. Come on. Almost there. Gotcha. Ow. Come on. Come on. We're almost there. Huh? Aha! Give me your loots. This might be the last one left. On the topic of writing, I'm also amused by the fact that the guy goes like zoom, zoom, zoom when he's dashing around. So my belt's level 5, this is level 8. Gain 40 water affinity, 4 water. I mean, gain 40 water affinity, 40 health, 35 water resistance, small reductions and other stuff. Honestly, the health and resistance, I think, is enough to be worth it. Oh, I just accidentally pressed down on the D-pad. I mapped that to down on the D-pad. Whoops. That looks like not great. I think I just replaced that, actually. These boots are level 4. My current ones are level 7. That's probably not a good sign. I mean, 6. 50 health and mana. I don't think I want to lose that right now. Probably. Alright. It says meet Brekka. Why was that? Anyway. I now have money for the glasses. I have 6 Dragon Balls. Figuring out where the last one's going to be is going to be a little rough, perhaps. I don't know. I found all the ones so far pretty quickly, but I'm definitely a little concerned the last one, because of the size of the overworld. It could kind of be anywhere. I'm trying to think. Maybe an earlier location in the game that I might have skipped or something. Or even in something weirdly obscure. He won't go into swamps without good reason. I guess the question there is whether the swamps are going to be a quest-related thing, or if they're going to be a side quest-related thing or a main story-related thing. Either way, I can't go in yet. Hello, loot. Almost shocking amounts of loot. Tell you what, I'll focus on the things I've taken care of so far, and then we'll go from there. So I'll head back to the main town, Thelos, where Brekka's waiting for me, but I still won't meet Brekka. And I'll buy those glasses and tell the guy about the portals that I've closed. And then once I have the glasses... Wait, where's... No, Atchet's also at the capital, isn't he? He's at the inn, I think. Alright, so I'll meet Atchet also with all the stuff I got. And then we'll go meet Voldemort. And I'm sure he'll be pleased. Yes, hello, cowardly sir. I've closed all the reopened portals.
Very good indeed. Here's the reward you were promised. Oh, Sir Reuben, you... Shut up.
Thank you, but this has been bugging me. May I ask you one question?
Go ahead.
If that bard bothers you so much, why don't you fire him? No one could blame you. I mean, he's not even really singing or rhyming properly. He's just taunting you while playing a tune. That's because I didn't hire him. My enemies did.
Your enemies hired a bard for you. Well, when I say enemies, it's more like... creditors.
Ah.
Sir Reuben's got great wealth to pay, to send adventurers away. However, when it comes to debt, he's far more likely to play dead.
the fucking bastard doesn't even try. I don't even know what's worth the insults or the horribly put together lyrics. I believe that's the whole point of it. I'll leave you to your misery. Well, we learned something today. Also, I did not see the pop-up. How much money did I get? I probably had about 6 grand, so I probably got about 2 grand for that. Alright. Not the biggest thing ever, because I made over 1 grand this episode, but it's something. It's something to work with. I at least can definitely afford some glasses and potions now.